Hello everyone. Today we will take up chapter 18 of social studies, that is the revolt of 1857. Let's first understand the reasons behind the revolt of 1857. India has trade relations with other countries since ancient times. India was famous for its spices, perfume, cotton, silk clothes and precious stones. In 1498, the famous Portuguese explorer Vasco da Gama discovered a sea route to India and landed at Calicut in Kerala. This proved to be the turning point in India's trade relations with Europe. Around 1680, a group of 100 London-based merchants got permission from the British Queen Elizabeth I and established the British East India Company. Their main trading center was in and around Surat. The Mughal Emperor Jahangir gave them permission to open a factory at Surat. Later, they established trading centers at Bombay, that is Mumbai, Calcutta, that is Kolkata, Madras, that is Chennai. Battle of Plassey. In Bengal, the British disobeyed the rules given to them by the ruler Nawab Siraj-ud-Daulah and declared war against Siraj-ud-Daulah. This battle came to be known as the Battle of Plassey and was fought in 1757. Nawab Siraj-ud-Daulah was defeated in this battle and Britishers became very powerful in Bengal. There were many kingdoms in India at that time and rulers often fought against each other. The British took the advantage of this situation and captured large parts of India. The unjust British rule. The British were interested only in making money. They forced Indian farmers to grow crops like cotton and indigo needed for their industries and not allowed them to sell to anyone else. The British gave very low price for the crop, that is why Indian farmers became very poor. The British brought machine-made clothes from England and sold them in the Indian market. The Indian weavers could not compete with the machine-made clothes. This led to the failure of Indian traditional industries. British passed unjust laws to attain political control over India. One such law was the Doctrine of Lapse by Lord Dalhousie. This law stated, if a king did not have a son, after his death, his kingdom would be taken over by the British. They imposed heavy taxes on the farmers. All the Indians became dissatisfied with the British rule. Indians wanted the British rule to come to an end. The Revolt of 1857. The year 1857 is a landmark in the history of India. This year witnessed the First War of Indian Independence, also called the Revolt of 1857. The revolt was started by the Indian soldiers who were serving the British Army, as they refused to use the guns because they heard that the new cartridge were greased with the fat of cows and pigs. This hurt the feelings of the Hindu and the Muslim soldiers. The revolt was started at Meerut, where soldiers refused to use the cartridges. Soon it spread to the northern and the central India. The soldiers were joined by farmers, craftsmen, and other section of the Indian society. They proclaimed Bahadur Shah Zafar as the Emperor of India. The leaders of this revolt were Mangal Pandey, Nana Sahab, Tatiya Tope at Kanpur, रानी लक्ष्मीबाई एट झांसी, बेगम हजरत महल ऑफ अवध, कुंवर सिंह एक्सेट्रा. हाउएवर द ब्रिटिश टर्म दिस रिवोल्ट एज द म्यूटनी ऑफ 1857. रिजल्ट्स ऑफ द रिवोल्ट. Since the British had more soldiers and better weapons, they suppressed this revolt. Moreover, the revolt failed as it did not spread to all parts of India. It did not receive support of all the people. There was insufficiency of money and weapons to fight such a huge power. Indians considered it as the first war of independence. Many Indians were killed or sent to jail. Bahadur Shah Zafar was forced to leave India. This mutiny united the Indians against the British. The rise of nationalism was an important result of this revolt. The revolt marked the end of the rule of British East India Company. After this revolt, the British Queen directly started to rule India through her representative called the Viceroy or the Governor General. So students, I hope you have understood the chapter. Thank you for watching the video.